なんですけど、ね、すごくいいよ。
So I will invite people.
Jamie's gonna go.
morning, everybody. My name is Sylvester. It's a privilege for me to be here to celebrate with the family of David Walker, his life, and his time on earth. We are here to celebrate his life with David's surviving children, Dayton, Jason, Odin, and Ruth. We are here with the family, with the brother Jim, Erickson, and then the sisters Laurie, Hoffa, and Carrie. I hope I'm not missing anybody. Okay, and we're also here with the nieces and nephews, and friends and colleagues of David. In our little service this morning, we are going to be reflecting on the life of David and how he impacted each and every one of us. And we'll be reflecting on his life, picking up readings from the scriptures. So we begin our celebration today. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, hear our prayers for your servant David, whom you have summoned out of this world. Forgive his sins and failings, and grant him a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Let him pass unharmed through the gates of death to dwell with the blessed in light, as you promised to Abraham and his children forever. Accept David into your safekeeping, and on that great day of judgment, raise him up with all the saints to inherit your eternal kingdom. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. I will now invite Jenny to lead us in the first reading.
Reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 25, verse 6 to 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wine strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will all be participating in the responsorial psalm. I will read the response, which we all respond when I invite you. The response is, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right path for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Now I invite you to lead us in the second reading.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to Timothy, chapter 4, verse 6 to 8. As for me, I'm already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We will now listen to the second hymn, Take on Me, by reading from From the Holy Gospel according to John. John chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. Whoever comes to the Father must come through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When I was reading about the life of David, one thing that stands out is that his life is an expression of what life is. He likes to play golf. I'll read what this guy said about life being like a golf. He's a mechanic. He fixes cars. He likes racing cars. And life is like a race. There's always a beginning. There's always an end. And because he's a mechanic, in between the beginning and the end, if we get into trouble, somebody comes to help us. And then his greatest hobby is being with his family. So that kind of expresses what life is all about. In life, you cannot talk about life without thinking of family. We all came from a family. You cannot talk about life without a beginning and then an end. You cannot talk about life without the twists in life, the ups and downs with life. So that is what David is kind of asking us to reflect on as we celebrate his life. 1969, there was joy in the family of the parents of David. Great joy because a child has been born. From the moment he was born, he started driving his own race car. And as he was driving his own race car, he picked some people along. First, he picked his wife. And then, along the line, he started picking his kids, one by one. The good thing about his life is not just that he was driving his own car, he was also there supporting people who get into trouble along the way, fixing their cars. So that is what life is all about. Our ability to impact on other people, especially impacting on their life positively. There's this hymn that I would like to share with you. It's not an easy road. We are traveling to heaven for many other times on that way. It's not an easy road, but the Savior is with us. His presence gives us joy every day. No, no, it's not an easy road. No, no, it's not an easy road. me, and brightens the journey, and light is everywhere below. As we make that journey through life, the personality and the importance of Jesus comes to bear. That is why in the Gospel of today, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let your hearts not be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. There are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you. And when I'm gone to prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to myself, so that wherever I am, you may be there also." So in that journey of life, we need somebody that we trust, somebody that loves us, irrespective of who we are. Somebody that is always there for us, even when we are unfaithful. And that person is Jesus. That's the assurance he is giving us today, to make that journey with him. If we make the journey with Jesus, it becomes much, much easier. There is a meaning that comes to life when we make that journey with Christ. Dying at 54 is dying young. But the greatest gift in life is not how many years you live. The greatest gift in life is having lived a life of love. David lived a life of love. He loved his family. He cared for them. He loved his friends. He loved what he was doing or what he did in life. And that is really what matters at the end. Because if you live for 120 years and you never experience love, your life is emptiness. If you live for a day and you have the fullness of love, your life is full. So as difficult as it is for you, the family, be assured that David is fulfilled life, because his life is a life of love, a life of sacrifice, a life of supporting other people. And that's what I want us to go home with. Let us all go home emulating these qualities, joining with Christ always, living a life of love, and then our readiness to support those God, in one way or the other, bring our way. Amen. We'll now listen to the final hymn, the final song, rather, the love song by Tesla. before the final prayers, reflect on this as if these are David's parting words for us. Life is like a round of golf with many twists and turns, but the game is much too sweet and short to cut the shots you have missed. Sometimes you will hit it straight and far. Sometimes the pots run through. But each round has its wayward shots and troubles to play through. So always swing with heart and courage, no matter what they lie. And never let the hazards destroy the joy inside. And keep a song within your heart. Give thanks that you can play, for the round is far too short and sweet to let it slip away. So if this is the last time we speak, then may I say, life with you was good, my friend. And I will see you on the 19th one day. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for the life of your son and your servant David. We thank you for the blessings you granted him while on earth. We thank you for the challenges he faced. Even his failures, we thank you. In all the times he has failed you, out of human weakness, we ask for your mercy upon him. In all the times you have granted him victory and granted him joy, we celebrate. In a very special way, we pray you, Lord, to be there for his family. Lord Jesus Christ, you were there for Mary and Martha at the death of their brother Lazarus. You were there to console them and to encourage them. We pray you, Lord, to be there for the family of David. Give them the grace to look beyond the darkness of death to the bright light of the resurrection. Into your hands, O Lord, we humbly entrust our brother, David. In this life, you embraced him with your tender love. Deliver him now from every evil, and bid him enter eternal rest. The old order has passed away. Welcome him now into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, no weeping nor pain, but the fullness of peace and joy. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. So once again, I want to thank you for being there for this family. And as you know, there's still another program in Verba. Thank you.
That does conclude the services here at the funeral home for the last Auden and the rest of the family. I want to thank you all for being here. Your presence truly means more than words can say. Like Father said, there is another service in Bell at 2 o'clock at the Country Club there. Obviously, you are all invited. I'm pretty sure you all know anyway. And I'll leave you with the final thought that while David may no longer be with us physically, he'll always be with us in our hearts, in our thoughts, and in our prayers, and that way he's never truly going to be gone. So again, thank you all for being here, and God bless each and every one of you.
At least it was a bigger print, so I could kind of see it. Good job.
Mike's laughing at me. It's like, no, I wasn't. It's like, I saw Jamie Kennedy.
No, I heard it. She squeaks.
I would.
You going out there too?
Yeah.
I'll buy a beer.
You and I. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to run down to the farm first. We're going to stay at the farm today.
That ain't that far of a journey, but still.
So, 2 o'clock, party. 3 o'clock, I want that video.
Okay.
4 o'clock, open mic.
Yep.
Sure.
So, I really want to
plan. I don't have a plan, but that's
13 minutes.
Oh, it's 13.
I thought it was an hour.
Whatever. Oh. We can roll it.
Yeah.
Me want some coffee.
Shut up.
So, I want to have everybody. So you gotta walk the street, do it.
Yeah.
Live or whatever.
But yeah, we could just turn that on and read.
I'm on the bright blue USA.
Looking pretty snazzy there, Cola.
Yeah.
Lots of, what it was, Rock Crosser Soakers.